Hello, I'm back again after a couple of weeks of being indoors. I've got some, well, a couple of new things to show, but lots of stuff that I've just been digging out because there's not much else to do at the moment. And I noticed from what I got that's new and looking on the price that things go for these days, everything I've got here costs a tenner or less. And I think that's the way to go ahead in these times. So let's start off with some hip hop. I showed some hip hop last time, and I've been going through quite a lot of what I've got. And a few months ago, I sold some records to a guy, and he was telling me how lots of really great 90s hip hop cost loads now if you want to get the albums. But the 12 inches, they don't really cost anything. They don't seem to have any value in them, even though they're absolutely classic 12 inches, and the albums that they come from sell for 50, 60, 70 quid and up. So something like this, which is a wonderful 12 inch award tour by a Tribe Called Quest, you can get this for like a fiver now, and it's amazing, huh? Brilliant. And one that I was really enjoying recently, Mos Def, Universal Magnetic. This was his first big tune. And was released on Raucous Records, which was very much the underground hip hop label of the moment in the late 1990s, where everybody was getting in the quite, everybody was loving everything that they came out. And they did some great releases. Their star burned very brightly for a brief period, and then just wasn't really so good anymore. But one thing they did really nicely is they always had really nice sleeve designs for their singles. And this was a particularly nice one on the back as well by Mos Def. That's a classic. This is another nice one as well. Reflection Eternal. Lovely B-side here, 2000 Seasons. Really good. And I've got quite a few of these 12 inches, and it was just really nice going through them. And they've aged well, I have to say. Beautiful stuff. So yeah, enjoying the 12 inches there. This is a new one I got. Well, it's not new, obviously. It's an old one, and it's a great sort of good old soul and funk record from the late 70s, with I'd say three pretty solid tracks on it, and a cover which perhaps might turn you off. This is by Alon, is it called? Or Arlon? Alon. And the album is called Cream City. And it's a nice little groovy album, this one. The three tracks that really picked out my ears, if you can pick out your ears, caught my ears. Rock and Roll Gangster, nice sort of, so a lot smoother than the title suggests. And then it's got some nice, actually I can't see the track listing here. It's got some nice, sort of slightly more instrumental things, Summer Love and Magic, is it Magic Night? Yeah, Magic Night. Definitely kind of groovy, going into the sort of two-step territory. Really nice, slightly a curious cover, which might explain why it's not so well known and is very affordable. Or maybe there were just lots and lots of copies available, but it's worth having a listen through if you like that sort of late 70s, slightly sort of soulful, getting into a disco-y bit. I mean, it's hit and miss. Not every song's a winner on this one, but the good ones I really like. Some really sort of breezy, sort of slightly jazzy, funky instrumentals. Really nice. Are they instrumentals? I think they are. I'm telling myself in my head that they are. Now, this album is a really, I love this, and I've been listening to it non-stop for the last fortnight, pretty much. And it was one of those discoveries on the internet that I just saw, and it looked curious, and I listened, and I was hooked. The name of the group is Batty Mamzelle. And the album is called I See the Light. Now, this album is kind of hard to categorize in many ways. It's funk, but it's also rock, kind of psychedelic in some ways. And it's got a lot of Latin touches, and it's made by a band from Trinidad. And you can tell that because they have a very heavy presence of steel drums throughout this. So steel pans is their big thing. You can actually see the band on the back there, and there's their setup. And it's just lovely, this album. I really, really rate it. And you can get this for very little. And it's really, really funky. The bass and the drumming on this album is superb, of the highest order, I have to say. And it's got good tunes on it. If it had like some open drum breaks or something like that, I'm sure it would sell for hundreds of pounds, but it goes for a tenner or less, and it's definitely worth checking out. It goes into some sort of psychedelic sort of wigged out bits, which add a nice little shade to it. But all the way through, I find it very, very listenable. Parts of it, you could perhaps find a parallel with a group like Symandy or something like that. But it's sort of on its own thing. It's very, very funky. And that's all I ask for, really. And it's really great. It's slightly lurid cover art, if you like. Apparently, Batty Mamzel is a word for dragonfly in Trinidad. And it also means crazy lady, which I think you can see on the cover. But really worth checking this album out. Really interesting. Lot going on. I mean, if you have a low tolerance for steel drums, well, okay, maybe it won't be your thing. But Trinidad in the 70s, I think this was actually recorded in London in the 70s sometime. But yeah, Trinidad is like a hotbed of funk, basically. And a lot of collectors really go out for those Trinidad tunes, because it's really funky, and they sometimes throw in a bit of the steel pans and everything to give it their own twist. But this is great. You can tell, I mean, it says in the story on the back that they had a rollicking live show, which they struggled to put onto record, but they finally managed it here. Sadly, they broke up after this one album, but lovely. I can't talk about it enough. I've talked about it for ages. Now, just a few more in the cheap and cheerful section. Another thing I've been noticing on Instagram and things like that, there's very much a taste these days amongst a lot of people for a style of music called UK street soul, which was very big, I guess, sort of early 90s was like its big period. That's what I associate it with. And basically, it's just sort of R&B music from the time, which is quite clunky, very heavy drums and very, very, very big bass. And there's some great, great songs, a lot of which, I mean, some tunes which are very expensive and sought after, but there's loads of them which are great, which you can get for like £2, and brilliant stuff. Just to pull out an example, this is a lovely one, the Urban Street Soul Orchestra, helpfully named. The B-side of this, Soul Singer, is fantastic. Taking a sample from Benny King, but it's got the sound of that British street soul thing, which is big bass, a certain funkiness to it, the vocals in their own sort of way. There's something very particular about it, which I love. And I remember I got this when it came out, $4.99 from Red Records in Brixton, I think. But you can now get this for like £2 or £3, and it's a lovely little thing. I love it, definitely. Perhaps a bit more well-known is this classic 12-inch as well, Jill Francis, Make Love to Me. Beautiful, beautiful stuff. And I think you can probably get this for pretty cheap these days as well. Again, it's just bass all the way, and some slightly clunky drumming. No, not so much, actually. But this is a lovely song. Really good. I think this got sampled in a jungle track as well, as I remember from the fog of my memory. And just an album which perhaps goes with this, Sinclair. Again, I remember I got this when I was about 15, I think, when I got this. Again, this sadly is not very good pressing, but bass is all heavy on this, and his somewhat smoky vocals over the top, but great. And it kind of bridges the line between reggae music and soul music in the UK. You can feel the reggae influence on a lot of this. One of the choruses from the song is actually, I think, from Louisa Mark's song, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, great songs on here. I Want You Back is a nice one. I Want to Know Why. Ain't No Casanova, that was a good one, yeah. Anyway, that's an interesting one. And just a few things that I've been listening to lately on the cheap and cheerful side of things. Anyway, until next time.
Very far away to be with us tonight.